What a crowd. You guys are fantastic. Thank you very much for your warm welcome. Don't forget to give them the same appreciation when they come out here. Very excited. Archie was a little bit nervous, you know, like a deer in front of a headlight. So you make him feel welcome when he gets out here. Welcome to That's Good Footy, the only live and interactive footy panel show. This is where the fans meet the players and the players meet the fans. You'll understand what that means as the night goes on. These shows are for the passionate supporters because it gives you a more sense of a connection. This is where you'll get to see the players in a different light. Who wants to meet them? Yeah! Okay, let's get on with it. Please welcome to the show. He's our first panellist. He was born on the 25th of April 1994. He's played a total of 157 games and he's kicked 279 goals. He made his AFL debut back in 2013. When he plays for the Essendon Football Club, he wears the number... 5 on his back. Could you please welcome to the stage, Jake Stringer. That's good. Very good. You're in fine voice. I like it. It's wonderful that you're showing that much enthusiasm, especially for Jake. I was chatting to him out in reception. I was just saying, oh, how are you feeling, mate? He goes, I feel bloody good, mate. And that's exactly the answer that I wanted to hear, because... On Saturday, round one, selection, guess who's in? I hope. I haven't even given anything away. Yeah. Well, anyway, how are you, mate? Let's go through it again.
Going good, going well. Yeah. So, had to tick off last Friday, which was a little scratch match. Got through and it's all systems go for me.
How good is that? It's exciting. Let's not leave him sitting out the back. He'll be thinking, what's going on? I'm all a bit nervous about all this. He's our second panellist. He was born on the 26th of March 2002. He's played a total of 21 games and kicked a total of 9 goals. He made his AFL debut back in 2021. And when he plays for the Essendon Football Club, he wears the number 16 on his back. Could you please welcome to the stage, Archie Perkins. Welcome both Jake and Archie to the show. It's Archie's first time, so as I said, go easy on him. Nice to have him here, though. How are you, Arch? Tell us a little bit about how your week's been, what you thought was going to be happening this evening. What's going on?
Yeah, very good. Happy to be here. Excited for the season. I thought it was more like footy club, change rooms, sort of. But good to be here.
Yeah, good. You can see he's lost his gorgeous locks. They've gone. All you ladies, yeah. A few ladies are disappointed. But he feels all right. He's, you know, fresh and new. Ready for a new season. Let's get into it. This is a footy panel show. We want to get into it with our first segment. It's called Tell Me More. No idea what I walked into. This is good. Now listen, each week we ask the panellists their thoughts on things happening in football. For those of you that don't know, these shows are pretty light-hearted. There's nothing serious here. So off the top, I just want to point out, we're not trying to solve world diplomacy here. We just want to have a chat with the boys and get their insight into how things are going on at the club inside and out. Let's talk about some positives off the cuff, boys. Essendon in 2021 were the fourth highest scoring side in the competition. You've got a host of goal kickers, but the majority of the goals were mainly kicked through you, Jake, Waller, Jonesy, 2 metre Peter, and you recently retired, Carl Hooker. Now, 2 metre Peter gives you an excellent target down forward, but with Anthony out at the minute and the injury to Jones and Hooker gone, where do you see your goals coming from in 2022?
Yeah, good question there. Still trying to work that out. Hopefully Perko kicks a few more. That'd be nice. Yeah. I think there's going to be a good spread of goal kickers. Kane Baldwin, he'll be probably close to getting a game. Peter Wright. I think he'll come on again. I think the midfielders too. I think you'll get Darcy Parrish and a couple of those floating forward, and hopefully they can hit the scoreboard as well.
Yeah, good. I bring that up because, Archie, you obviously kicked two against the Saints the other night, right, which was bloody wonderful. How are you feeling about season 2022? What's because there's going to be a two-winded question here. You played at Brighton Grammar. You played at the Sandringham under-18s. Where did you play your best footy? What's your best asset?
Yeah, I think I'm a very attacking player, so my best footies usually happen in the forward half of the ground, so goals are a part of that. So last year, I think I should have kicked probably a bit more than I did. But yeah, coming into my second year, if I can be a bit more accurate in front of goal, I think they should start to flow a little bit more easy.
Okay. And when you were playing at either Sandringham or at Brighton Grammar, what sort of role did you have down there?
Yeah, well, when I was a bit younger, I wasn't as much in the midfield. I was more forward. So, but then, yeah, well, didn't really play, though, in year 12. So, but, yeah, in year 11, I was more that forward mid hybrid sort of a player. So I think that's something you can expect this year at AFL level.
And you happy with your development thus far, moving into, like, obviously now your second season at the Bombers? Where do you see your growth?
Yeah, I think my running ability has improved a lot from last year to this year. I think I've always been pretty fit, but running it in an AFL game is a lot different. So I think I've improved that aspect, so that there'll be a lot of growth there, getting to more contests, especially in the forward half. And then I think flying for my marks a bit more, so taking a few more grabs, especially inside 50, and then, kicking more goals. So nice. I think that they're my areas for growth.
Yeah, good. You've obviously, Jake, this is a question open to both of you now. A few veterans at the club, but you've had some really good, we'll call them green shoots, that have come through. The likes of Nick Cox, we can talk about Archie Perkins as well, but there's lots of other individuals that have come on. Where do you see the growth for the club moving forward with these guys?
Yeah, I think that's where our growth's going to come from. It'll be Archie in his second year, Coxie in his second year. Who else we got? Reedy, who he's played one game. He'll come back in the next 3 or 4 weeks. So there's plenty of young, raw talent. And also, like Darcy Parrish, Jai Caldwell, like he hardly played last year. He'll play round one and hopefully gets a good year out of him. So, and Sam Draper's another one. He's played 30 games. So, I think our growth's going to come from that group, and hopefully myself and Darcy Parrish and Zach Merritt and Dylan Scheel and a few of the other boys can go to another level, and hopefully we're right amongst it.
Well, Darcy had a standout season last year. Obviously, it'd be wonderful to see him continue on in that form moving into 2022. You've got your vice-captain in Zach Merritt, and then also Dyson's been thrust into the captaincy yet again, which gives him great belief in the playing group. One thing that everyone talks about in football is cohesion. That's something that the group is starting to bring into that type of play. Do you feel that cohesion around the club at the moment, or it's still in the making, but it's there?
Yeah, it's definitely there. As when I first got drafted, like to the Bulldogs, I mean, I didn't talk to any of the older blokes. I was too scared. Whereas these young boys, they're in amongst it all the time. So, I mean, that's an instant start. They're never shy. All the young ones that walk in the door now, and they're able to be themselves.
Yeah, good. The Bombers had a year last year that surprised a few. Some exciting new additions came into the lineup, as I just spoke about. I thought a promising sign from your practice match against the Saints the other night was Nicholas Martin. He's a nice little find. He knows how to get the ball, and he doesn't mind getting in and under either.
Yeah, I was sitting in the box with Saki Merritt. He got subbed. And he had 16 half time. To half time.
Yeah.
And then Martin come on and had 16 to the other half. So I said it was like for like. He didn't take it too well, but...
who else should we be excited about down at the club? Archie, they're probably the guys that you're working with at the moment. Who else do you see as a bit of a standout down there?
I'd say Jai Caldwell, to be honest.
He's been mentioned.
Compromised year last year. So he's pretty much a new sort of really good midfielder to add to the mix. So I think he's one that everyone should expect to have a big year.
Yeah.
As Jake mentioned, I think the guys sort of on the depth sort of cusp of the team are like much more equipped for footy this year, including myself, Coxie. I think that sort of 22 to 28 sort of players will be a lot stronger. So that'll...
Better for the run.
Yeah, benefit our performances, I think.
Yeah, good. All right. And just to talk about for a minute the game against the Saints there the other night. It's obviously the most recent one that we can take any idea from and get a bit of an assessment. They got off to a bit of a fast start, but by the second you got the game back on your terms, what learnings did you kind of take from that? I know it's a, what are they called now, an AAMI series, JLT Cup, pre-season games, but what sort of learnings did you take from that game? It wasn't a bad result, to be honest, but you were just, end result, what was it, 9-17? It's probably a little bit accurate in that. It doesn't necessarily help the course, but what did you take from that hit out? I know you're in the stands, yeah. Jake, but like, what was spoken about within the club from that?
Yeah, well, I was in the coach's box, so I was lucky enough, but I actually had a Fox Footy interview at quarter time, and we couldn't have played a worse quarter of footy, and I'm thinking, oh my God, I'm going to walk down. And they're going to ask, how are the boys going? I'm going to be sitting there going, oh, they're going no good. But, oh, the boys going really well. Yeah, so
keep it positive.
Yeah. But I think that was really good for us to go through that period where there's been a lot of hype about us to actually, we were a little bit off in that first quarter. But, you know, by the time halfway through the second quarter, we got the game on our terms and we were dominant from then onwards. Mm. We just couldn't kick straight. That was our only sort of disappointment through the night.
Is that the thing? Is it that you're actually looking at the potential, and but is it more that the media or maybe even the fans, the expectation from everybody else is you finished off on such a high and you surprised so many people from 2021 that the expectation is even higher in 2022? Does that play?
No, I don't think it does. I think they were just probably a bit timid. Round one's around the corner. It's hard to stay focused on that present moment, and I think that's sort of probably where we fell away in that first quarter, and it was a good wake-up call. And as you said, from second quarter onwards, we were pretty dominant through the game. We just couldn't capitalise.
Yeah. And let's not put all our emphasis into pre-season games, everybody, all right? Let's get out there and get stuck into round one. And as I speak about it, but hey, it's all fresh and new for 2022. Round one action for the Bombers, get the season off to the right start. Big game, Country Festival, I think they're calling it.
Yeah.
All right, unique name, I like it. Up against the Cats at the home of footy, the Mighty G, 2:10 p.m. Saturday afternoon football. Tell me, Saturday afternoon football, 2:10 MCG, here's the sealer in front of people. You're going to have crowds there again.
I feel a bit sorry for Archie because he actually hasn't got to experience the full Essendon support.
Yeah.
He's had a pretty interrupted, obviously, through COVID and all that type of stuff. So you got a little taste at the start of last year, didn't you? But
well,
not much after that.
Anzac and couple
Dream
of other big
time.
Ones.
Yeah.
So both of you, what's the feeling like around at the club? Let's get out there. Let's get off to a nice start for 2022. But obviously, focusing on this first game, round one, against the Cats at the MCG. All pumped for it?
I'm more nervous about getting through training Thursday than the game. So I'll be excited Thursday night. But until then, I'll be just concentrating on getting through training.
One step at a time. Archie, what are your thoughts, mate?
Yeah, I couldn't really ask for a better sort of time slot. Saturday, Arvo, I've checked the weather. It's looking, it's looking good. 25, sunny, so get out there, it should be a good one. I'm really excited.
There you go. He's out there to play football, but he likes that the weather's going to be good too, and that's what I like about it, and that's bloody good. Ladies and gentlemen, that's our little chat with Archie and Jake. Please put your hands together for them. Thank you. Let's introduce the segment. It's called Simply the Best. You're simply the best. Better than all. All right, so what we're going to do here, boys, I'm going to ask you a series of questions. There's actually 13 in total. Each time that you think you know the answer to that question, I just want you to buzz in with the answer. Here we go. How many premierships has the Essendon Football Club won?
Jonathan.
Oh, jeez. Off the mark. Oh, I don't know. Was that Nathan? Let's go with Nathan.
16?
Yes, correct, mate. Well done. You're off the mark. Beautiful. Archie's turned it over. How many grand finals has your team played in?
Shannon?
Yes.
25?
No, Shannon, very close, without giving away a hint.
Nathan?
Yes, Nathan.
20?
No, you went the other way. It's 29. Bad luck. All right, here we go, boys. Who is your team's captain?
Shannon.
Shannon.
Dyson Heppel.
Correct. 1 point to you. Who wears the number 7 at your club?
Shannon. Nathan.
Oh, Shannon again.
Zach Merritt.
Correct. How many members does your club currently have? Closest to within 1,000. Was that Shannon?
Yep.
Shannon.
65,800.
Oh, mate. He's bloody good. It's 66,105. You got it. You've done it. Where did your team finish on the ladder at the end of the home and away season last year?
Shannon.
Shannon.
Eighth.
Yes, correct. Eighth it is. How many games did your team win last year at the end of the home and away season?
Shannon. Nathan.
Shannon.
12?
No. Nathan, would you like to have a go?
11?
Yes, 11 it is. All right. What year did your team win their last grand final?
Shannon.
Shannon.
2000.
And who did they play?
Shannon. Melbourne.
Yeah. Yeah, spot on. Well done. All right, it's 2 versus 5. Nathan, you're going to lift your game, my friend. How many points did you win that grand final by?
Shannon.
Oh, Shannon.
74?
No. Nathan.
62?
Oh, 60. Bad luck, so close. Who won the Norm Smith medal in that grand final?
Nathan.
Nathan? Was that Nathan? Sounded like Nathan.
Jimmy.
Jimmy? You want to say his full name?
Hurd?
James. Yes,
Hurd.
That'll do. James Hurd. Thank you, mate. That'll do. For 2 points, who was your club's leading goal kicker in 2021?
Shannon.
Shannon. For 2 points, can you tell me who?
Jake
How many
Stringer?
Goals? Jake Stringer's for 1 point. How many goals?
34.
How many?
34.
34, no. Keep going. Should I have a go, Nathan?
42.
Well, it's really funny because I saw it on two different sites. One was 41, one was 39. All right, but I can't give it to you because you didn't get either. All right, out of these three Essendon Grand Finals, listen to the full question before you buzz in, boys. Out of these three Essendon Grand Finals, which had the largest crowd in attendance? Was it A, 1993 versus Carlton? Was it B, 1965 versus St Kilda? Or was it C, 1985 versus Hawthorn?
Shannon.
Nathan. Shannon.
1985.
No. Nathan.
I think the 60, the St Kilda?
Yes, it was. 1965 versus St Kilda. Just for those playing along at home, 104,846. Here's your last question. What are we sitting on? 4 versus 6. Ooh. This is worth 2 points, all right? You've got to get both of them right for you to win, Nathan. Here we go. I will give you 3 Essendon players' names. You have to tell me what their combined jumper numbers add up to. Do not give me the answer until I've read out all 3 and then it's the first one in. Here's your first one. Tip and Woody. Heppel and McGrath. Go.
Nathan?
Yes, Nathan.
62?
No. Shannon, do you want to have a go, mate?
67.
Oh, no. Neither. 65. McDonald, Tipping Woody is 43, Dyson Heppel is 21, and McGrath is 1. All right. One more. One more chance. Here we go. I said 43. Here's your 3 names. Parrish, Smith, Shiel.
Oh, no. Parrish, Smith and who?
Parrish, Smith and Shiel.
Shannon?
Nathan? Shannon.
17.
Spot on. You got it. Well done. Shannon, you are our winner. Nathan, bad luck, mate. It was a bloody good attempt. You were exceptionally close. Shannon, as the winner, are you two brothers or friends? Because one of you, being the winner, is Shannon. You've just won two tickets to go and see Essendon versus Geelong, MCG. Congratulations, Shannon. As a runner-up, Nathan, you get a footy. You get a football for that. What'll happen is see the lovely Sandy. She'll come over and grab your details. You fill it all out, and I'll send the tickets out to you tomorrow. Good on you, Shan. Thanks, boys. Good. There we go. Simply the Best was proudly brought to you by Yamaha and the Big Picture People. They are the experts in surround sound home theatre technology. The Big Picture People are located in Hobbs Crossing, Clyde North, Water Garden, South Morang, Cheltenham and the Gold Coast. That was bloody wonderful. Well done, boys. That was a good little segment. I enjoyed that. What do you think, Archie?
It's great.
I knew you had your microphone down. I just wanted to catch out. Well done, mate. Forty-five seconds on the clock. Your time starts. You all right? Sorry. Oh, good. Your time starts now. Number 43.
Tip and Woody. Anthony Tip and Woody.
Correct. Number 21.
Dyson Apple.
Correct. Number 31.
Zach Reed.
Correct. Number 2.
Sam Draper.
Correct. Number 35.
Matthew Guelphy.
Correct. Number 4.
Kyle Langford.
Correct. Number 7.
Zach Merritt.
Correct. Number 32.
Pass.
Josh Ayer. Number 11.
Will Snelly.
Correct. Number 27.
Mason Redmond.
Correct. Number 36.
Garrett Donoghue.
Correct. Number 12.
Tom Cutler.
Correct. Number 33.
Braden Ham.
Correct. Number 14.
Jordan Ridley.
Correct. Number 34.
Andrew Phillips.
Correct. Number 17.
Pass.
James Stewart. Number 38.
Cody Brand.
Correct. Number 19. Give it to you.
Nick Hind.
Yes. All right. What do you finish up with? How do you go, Mitchell? 14. That's a bloody good score. Well done. 14. Mate, that's brilliant. William, you got your work cut out for you, but you're all prepared, aren't you? Yes, you've got your score paddle. Archie, how you feeling, mate?
Yeah.
All right, well, let's see how
Should
you go.
Right.
You've got a score of 14 to beat. You've got 45 seconds on the clock. You're ready to go, William? Archie's ready to go. Let's see what we can do. Your 45 seconds starts now. Number 20.
Pass.
Peter Wright. Number 1.
Andrew McGrath.
Correct. Number 16.
Me. Arch Perkins.
Yes. Number 3.
Dust Parrish.
Yes. Number 23.
Harrison Jones.
Correct. Number 6.
Pass.
Jai Caldwell. Oh, you've said his name a bit. Number 9.
Dylan Chiu.
Correct. Number 13.
Nick Cox.
Correct. Number 10.
Aaron Francis.
Correct. Number 18.
Michael Hurley.
Number 24.
Dick Bryan.
Correct. Number 25.
Jake Stringer.
Correct. Number 5.
Devin Smith.
Correct. Number 28.
Pass.
Alistair Lord. Number 8.
Ben Hobbs.
Correct. Number 29. I'll give you this if you can get it. Number 29.
Jake Kelly.
Correct, you got it. Finished up with a total score of 11. Just pipped at the post, William. Just pipped at the... Mitchell, do you know what that means, though, don't you? You win. Congratulations.
Oh, yeah.
Brilliant. Well done to both of you. That was great. I know the thanks should go here, but you guys were fantastic turning over those paddles. That was brilliant. William, we've got a runner-up prize for you. It's a football. How good's that? All right, we might be able to get that signed for you from the boys later. And Mitchell, I don't know how this is going to go down, set of headphones, courtesy of Yamaha. They're earbuds, all right? They're valued at $179. They're yours. Wow. Well done. Congratulations. You can thank Jake for that, all right? And thanks, Mum. Thank you very much. That was great. Thanks, William. Well done. All right, that was great. Thank you very much to everyone getting involved in that. What I want to do now, we don't need any contestants for this particular segment. We're just going to ask you guys some random questions. You feel free to give me whatever answer pops into your head, and we'll go with it from there. It's a segment that we like to call What Can I Say? So Archie's up here, he's going, I love all these songs, this is great. Never heard one of them. It's really cool. But it is called What Can I Say, Mate? So you just, the question's directed to both of you and it doesn't matter how you answer it. Which one of these things gets you pumped the most before a game? Is it the smell of deep heat, fresh cut grass, pulling on a jumper, strapping on the boots, a footy in your hands, or the sound of the crowd?
Crowd, I reckon.
Yeah.
Crowd. In and out.
Crowd?
Crowd for me, too.
All right. Well, hope you'll get used to that on Saturday. Are you happy to see the banners back?
Didn't know they were back.
Yeah, I'm happy they're back.
Yeah, good. Just go out and wave to everybody. That'll be fine. The siren is gone. You need a goal to win the game. Who do you hope has got the ball in their hands to do it?
2 metre.
Yep. I want it myself.
Yep.
Peter Wright.
Peter Wright. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, cool. Essendon supporters are?
Very loyal.
Passionate
and loyal. Stewie's talking about. That's good. Which AFL club do you like to beat the most?
Carlton, Collingwood.
Cue forms to the left. Yeah. Archie?
Oh, well, I've only been 1 year of us, but Carlton was good and Collingwood. No, but he lost to Carlton. Sorry, Collingwood.
Yeah.
Collingwood.
Okay, all right. Do you prefer a day or a twilight grand final?
Day.
Twilight,
okay. You've been reincarnated as an animal. What sort of an animal would you hope to be?
A gorilla.
Probably a domestic dog.
A domestic dog?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Strange things happen at this show, Archie. Who's the most cultured or thinks they are down at the club?
James Stewart, for sure.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, James Stewart.
Yeah, cool. All right. Who's the funniest bloke, or again, who thinks they are down at the club?
Probably Drapes. Thinks he's funny.
Okay. What do you think?
Probably, personally, I think James Stewart is pretty funny. Jakey's quite funny as well. Sometimes at your own expense.
Yeah. Just had to throw that little disclaimer in there. I like that. Being an AFL footballer to you is?
A dream.
Yep.
Exciting.
Beautiful. Excellent. Who's a bit tight with their money at the club? Who's a bit tight with their money at the club?
Andy McGrath.
I don't really know, but apparently a lot of people say Mason Redmond.
That is also very true.
Yeah, you can vouch for that. Yeah. All right. In your opinion, who down at the club has got the most swagger? Or again, thinks they have? Nice. You ladies couldn't see that, could you? No.
Probably Jonesy, a little bit.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
All right. You've been given the opportunity to do one of the following things. Parachute out of a plane, take a hot lap in a V8 supercar, go hot air ballooning, or swim with the sharks. Which one are you choosing?
I don't like any of them, but if I had to choose one, I'd probably go on with the sharks.
Okay.
I can jump out of the plane.
All right.
Yeah.
All right. Good. What is your favourite ground to play on around Australia apart from the MCG?
Optus.
Marvel?
Optus.
Optus. All right. Playing for the Essendon Football Club is?
Exciting.
Exciting?
I'm just fortunate. Fortunate to be there, yeah.
Okay, all right. You've been told you're about to go into lockdown. What's the one thing you make sure you take with you?
My Switch.
Ah.
we've got a little gang that like gets on and plays together.
Yeah.
So
that goes 100%.
Well, because you can't do anything when you go into lockdown. So it's like 23 hours you sit there and play. Play footy in the other 2 hours.
Perfect. All right, Arch.
Girlfriend.
Ah. It's probably about. That's actually probably about the smartest answer I've ever heard on this. That's not too bad. That's, yeah, all right. What's better, mark or goal of the year?
Probably mark.
Okay.
Goal, I'd say, actually.
All right. Who's your Brownlow chip for 2022?
Bontempelli.
Okay.
Can't go past him.
Yep.
Oh, yeah, the Bontempelli or Petrarca.
Yep, all right. When you're filling up with petrol, do you round it off to an even amount or just go until it clicks?
I used to sit there and do the old soft click, right, try and get it to on the thing, but I don't have time anymore.
Yeah.
I usually go to the same number every time. At the moment, I'm being a little bit more
not bad.
Stingy.
So there were reasons behind these questions. Yeah, I like it. Essendon Football Club at the end of the home and away season this year will finish?
Hopefully in the top four would be nice, but hopefully we're just in the eight.
Yeah, good. Archie?
Yeah, in the eight, I reckon.
Good. Yeah. Do you think being interviewed prior to or during a game? Like, do you like being interviewed prior to or during the game?
I've had both. I'd probably prefer before than during.
Yeah. Like, what are you going to tell them at halftime? Are we going to come out and try and kick more goals? Or?
Well, I've come off a few words with a few different players and then straight into a camera and you've got to remember you can't swear, you can't do anything. Yeah. So it's sort of...
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a bit hard.
I hear you. Arch?
I've had neither. but I'd say I'd prefer pre-game.
Yeah, okay, good. Are you superstitious in regards to your preparation?
Absolutely not.
Good.
No, not at all.
Not at all. Good. You're a contestant on a reality TV show. What sort of show is it?
It's good for footy.
He's coming back. You know that, don't you? Bloody hell. Thank you. Well done.
He's too smart for me.
That was nice. Very good. Do you prefer to see the coach on the bench or in the box?
In the box.
Depends how you're playing, but Chuck never comes on the bench.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Who does their hair the most at the club? Spill the beans, boys.
Probably me a lot last year.
Yeah, between him and Sheely, there's a lot going on down that end of the locker room. So just sort of let them go, let them do their own thing.
All right, we'll go with that. In reflection, how much do you remember about your first game?
Well, quite a lot. We played very well that day, had a really good win, so it was pretty all smiles for my first game. I remember it pretty well.
Good for you. Excellent. I like it.
Mine's well and truly in the mind. My first ever opponent was my current coach.
Oh.
And I was sub at, is it Amy Stadium, the old Adelaide Oval?
Yep.
Yeah, we played the Crows. We were down by 12 goals and it was raining sideways, bit of hail, and they said, off you go, mate, go have a run. So, I went out for a quarter and it was horrible, but...
Wow.
Yeah, and then, so you know how they used to rope the square off?
Yep.
So they rope the square off and then they go, we need to get your numbers up with your GPS. And if you've been to Adelaide, it's, it's a bit 50-50. Yep. So I'm in the middle of the crowd running my first game, just copping abuse from everyone on the side. So, that was my first game, so that was exciting.
Wow. All right, there you go. Jesus. If there was only one form of entertainment, listening or viewing, which would you choose?
You'd have to see.
Yep.
No, I'd say music. I reckon
You
listen to music more than I watch television or things like that every day on the way to and from training. So
you're a man after my own heart. That's me too. You're applying for a position as a footballer, similar to a job interview. What do you write about yourself?
Avoid.
Avoid. Approach.
I'll go with that. All right. What do you think when you see a poster or merchandise of yourself?
I laugh. I often find it quite funny. Yeah, it's just humorous.
Yeah.
Aren't you? Yeah, you probably take a few seconds to see how you look, see if you like it or not, but yeah, be used to it, sort of.
Yeah, baby!
There you go. And what is your reaction when you see a kid with your number on their back?
That's the best part of footy.
Oh, good answer.
Yeah, it's pretty humbling.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, they're bloody good answers. I like them all. Well done, boys. You got through it. There you go. That was What Can I Say? Now I need to tell you about what's coming up in coming weeks. You guys would like me if I did another Essendon show, I presume, yeah? Well, then you've got to share it with as many people as you can. You've got to tell them all about it, and I'll get you two champions from the Essendon Football Club the next time that we do one of these shows. They probably won't be as good as these two, because how could they? Seriously. I mean, you know, Archie's first time, and Jake, he's just a veteran. But we need you guys to support us. We need you to come along and tell your friends, because that's the biggest thing. So I want to tell you about next week on the show. On March the 23rd, we're going back to Wednesday nights, which is good for us, because this AFL stuff and Tuesday nights and Thursdays, it's all over the shop. So we'll be back to you here. Thanks, Sam. On March the 23rd, Wednesday nights are back. We'll return to regular programming with St Kilda's Jack Higgins and Rowan Marshall. So if you've got any St Kilda fans, let them know. Then on March the 30th, we've got Richmond's Dylan Grimes and Toby Nankervis on the panel. Then on the 6th of April, then don't seem to like Richmond here, I don't know why. Then on April the 6th, we've got Western Bulldogs players Josh Dunkley and Aaron Norton. Now, you can only get your tickets through the That's Good Footy website, www.thatsgoodforfooty.com.au/events, or click on the links on the That's Good for Footy Facebook page. They'll take you through to the ticketing platform. The shows are hosted at the Mulgrave Country Club, which is out here opposite the old Arctic Park, VFL Park. Did you ever used to go to Arctic Park just to watch football? No? No, okay. It's all right. Just thought I'd ask. Just was curious. If you'd like to be kept informed of the show, so if you want to know when the next Essendon show is coming up, you go on and you register, and then we send you out an SMS, and that will let you know, and then you can go on and buy your tickets. It's pretty easy to do that. Simply go to the That's Good Footy Facebook page, like the page, and then simply register. Can I please get you to put your hands together for Sam and Sandy? I can't do the shows without those guys. Sam is an integral piece. Sandy looks after the door and all the hosting duties, so she's fabulous. There's only three of us that do all this, so, you know, it looks like 100 people put it together. There isn't. It's just us. Some of you would probably say, yeah, it looks like only three of you put it together. But we appreciate all your support, and we want you to come along and be part of it again. And whilst you're there and you're feeling jovial, please, while you get the chance now, before they rock out to the ground on Saturday at 2:10 p.m. against the Cats, put your hands together for Archie Perkins and Jake Stringer. Wonderful to have you boys on tonight. Always great. It's always a pleasure to see you. You're a quiet soul, but I know there's a lot about you that I love getting you back on the shows as often as I can. Archie, your first time. How'd you go tonight, mate? Was it everything you expected and a little bit less? Or?
Yeah, it was better than I expected. Great to meet a lot of passionate fans. So,
yeah. They're passionate. Great. Yeah, they're very passionate. We know that about them. We just wanted to say thanks very much to all of you for coming along and supporting the shows. We hope to see you at the next Essendon show. Until then, we wish you a very good evening. My name is Damien, and this has been the That's Good Footy panel show, and we'll see you soon. Thanks, everyone. Cheers, and good night. Thank you. We'll be right back.
tonight.